Okay, I'm working on framing one of my diamond paintings, and I looked into a lot of different methods, watched a lot of videos, and what I decided was to use these stretched canvases. I just ordered them from Walmart. They come in all different sizes. This one I've worked on, it's smaller, and basically I just get these cute little paints from the craft store, and I pick a color that complements my painting, and then I just keep putting layers on till, I don't know if you can see, but this one is still a little streaky, so that means it needs more paint. That's all I do, is just paint them a solid color, and then I'll show you when I mount this one and a couple that I finished, so you can see how easy it is. And again, you know, I am a stroke survivor, so I try to do as much as I can with my left hand. The repetition of using that hand is amazing. This hand is very weak, very uncoordinated, but I'm seeing huge improvements since I've started working on this diamond painting. That's it. Again, here's the packaged stretch canvas. You can mount them on the white canvas. I like painting the canvas to a nice, pretty color that'll complement it. Hi everybody. I'm gonna show you how I finished one of my diamond paintings. And then I'm gonna finish the second one so you can see how it happens. Now this is just a stretched canvas that I painted with an acrylic. I'm still pressing it down. And then I used double-sided tape. Simple. I cut away everything outside the framing square of the finished piece. And then I just press it down onto the canvas. I'm not real fancy with measuring and making sure it's exactly right on all sides. Here, I'm gonna finish this one now. I've prepared the back of it with a double-sided tape. And now I'm simply going to place it where I want it. Don't press down yet. If it's not perfect, I don't care. It's made with love. Hopefully someone will love it as much as I do. Now I'm going to start pressing in the middle and work out to the sides. Make sure it's flat. I've put extra tape in the corners because those tend to pop up a little bit. I need to work on flattening these better before I frame them. I feel the diamond moving. Oh, it's all right. I'll double check it before I'm done. And there you have the finished piece with a beautifully color-coordinated frame. It's that simple.